The question we need to ask ourselves in setting the agenda today is, what really is the problem of Nigeria? Why is Nigeria still the way it is? Why are we having an increasing security challenges in a geometrical progression? Why is there hunger in our land? Why is it that nations that we helped in the past, like South Korea and Malaysia, and even Dubai, has overtaken us? And we have become a laughing stock in the face of other nations. These are what will determine the kind of agenda we set for ourselves. But the way it is now, if we can only answer this question, then we might not set a proper agenda. But let me remind us, our number one agenda, Senator Alero, our number one agenda with your committee should be the people and nothing but the people. And we have a duty to make an agenda that guarantees happiness to every common man in this country. But because political power is a trust which can only be justified when used for the benefit of the common man. So our agenda must remain the people and nothing but the people. Now, in setting this agenda, I thought that since we have one government, Federal Republic of Nigeria, there would have been a joint action committee comprising of the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary, with you seated as Mr. Senate President, to discuss together before we separate ourselves to find solution. Today, the executive is speaking from different angle, judiciary is from a different angle, legislature is a different angle. But let me remind all of us, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished senators, that where a nation has failed, the legislature is held responsible. Because legislature is the pivot upon which the wheels of every arm of government rotates. We start what the executive does, and we start what the judiciary does. Without legislature, there can't be action of executive, and there cannot be an action of legislature. So I suggest that there must be a teamwork first. Even in the making of our budgets, we must understand, for instance, let me give you an example, let me take a practical approach. President Muhammad Buhari, what do you want to do for Nigeria? First question, I want to do A, B, C, D. Okay, let all the laws we make be geared towards making you achieve this. That makes the matter a simple task, and there will be progress in this land. A nation that is faced with extreme danger like Nigeria today should seek the wisest course of action, not of convention. There's so much of talk shop, like doing shop. And this is why today we're not able to come together with the executive, give them what they want to make sure they give the Nigerians what Nigerians need. So our laws must change. Our style must change. And if we keep doing the same old things, the same old ways, we shall keep getting the same old results. There will be no difference between the 8th Assembly and 9th Assembly if we do not change our style, even on the way we conduct the affairs of the Senate. We cannot carry all the projects at the same time. We don't have the money to carry it. I'm sure in the Senate now, we want to add more roads, more hospitals. Why the ones of last year have not been completed? I'm sure we're here now introducing more things. When the last one will pass in 8th and 7th Senate is still suffering from funding. Let us concentrate. In Igbo, we say, Abako, Abako, your mommy, ya abu ofofo. If you need interpretation, meet the Oji. Oji can explain to you what I mean. But the principle of concentration will create a foam out of any business of a man in the course of metabolic reaction. So, Mr. President, I wish this Senate well, and I wish you well. Please change the style and let's move this nation forward.